What is up, guys? Welcome back. Episode 40, Tibia Druid level 8 to 100 series. And as per usual, a little delay between videos, but we're still here. I didn't disappear. I had a pretty busy week last week. I was in and out. Doctor had some appointments, MRI, x-ray, bunch of shit. And we actually had two winter storms that were pretty, like, decent. Work was canceled for half a day, like, just the way my shift worked. It was, like, morning parts canceled, but we'll, like, revisit at lunch and end up going in for lunch. But Monday, as in yesterday, was canceled as well. So just a busy week and didn't really play much at all. I got to hunt for, like, 2 hours during rapid respawn on my night, which was awesome. I went to the Lion Sanctum, which I have a video of from a while ago, and it was crazy. Literally just switched between two rooms, was making, like, I had them on damage prey and I had XP boost, but I was making like 6.3k an hour solo and probably 700k an hour profit. So pretty good overall, but that's besides the point. We are focusing on Secret Agent Tooths, level 80. Gonna go revisit. This is what I like to do. Every 10 to 15 levels, I like to revisit a spawn and see if we can really push the maxes of that spawn. Mother Scarab's Lair is honestly a spawn I would hunt on like level 100 plus. If I was doing just, you know, power leveling, but for this, the video series, I don't really want to just, you know, do the same spawn the whole time. You know, I've jumped between a few spawns, but there's obviously, if you're going level to level 100, there's going to be two or three spawns that really are your priorities. And this is one of them. And it looks like someone's here, with a new Utama Vito or Mana Shield. I don't think a level 80 at Were Cave would be nearly as good as it used to be, but I could be wrong. I'll try it out in maybe next video. I definitely can't go without Mana Shield. I'll get some death protection, and even still I don't think it's gonna be viable at this level. Level 80 in the old school Mana Shield worked, but this is completely different. So we're gonna go here. I think like what, 500 or 600k an hour was probably what we get. Or is it more than that? Way more than that. I think it's like a KK an hour, but it's been so long. I have Ancient Scarabs on Damage Prey, which I think will be the best because I'll just light them up. My magic level is still not like crazy on this guy. Like 60 something with gear, probably 70. Yeah, so I mean, it's fair. But 10 out of 10 damage should, you know, yeah. You're going to hit for 300 plus on like 500, so. Oh, baby, this is going to be good. I think this XP is going to be fucking awesome. It's been so long since I've hunted here. I've literally just been like, anytime I come on my mages, it's just a savvy surface. Oh, let's not die first thing. That wouldn't be bueno. I do have great manas now, but they really don't mean that much. Because it's pretty hard for a mage to burn through all their mana at this level with mana void and whatnot. It's, I don't know, it's pretty tough. If you find a way to do that, like, that's impressive. Especially with the new magic shield, like, you can't really burn through all your mana. Oh, I might get a little cocky here. Death's never hurt for a video series. Oh my god. I must have bonus XP. Yeah, I've got some bonus XP as well from just a daily bonus, so. This should be, oh! Jesus. I don't know if I left-clicked there or what. But I just went, like, into the middle of that group of creatures. I'll probably do one lap, or two laps, I guess, and see what the XP is roughly, and then we'll go to our usual, you know, some music in the background. I think we're gonna level pretty quick here, though. Debatably faster than Savvy Surface. Just the damage output so much better. And that was one thing I really never put in enough thought into when I used to roll praise. It was always like, just get XP, get XP. But if you can kill, you know, mobs in 3 GFBs, you're going to kill so many more in an hour. It really, and it also depends on how long you're planning on hunting. If you're doing 20-minute hunts, then the XP is probably where, you know, will win in that time frame. But if you're doing an hour, over an hour, like, you're going to kill so many more that it might make more sense to go damage output. So 10 out of 10 damage. Okay, I don't really I don't feel super safe. I'm not going to loot anything. I mean, this character is strictly for the series and then will be PvP at some point. I don't know if I want a UE. What's going on here? I was going to say, I tried a UE, but it didn't work. Yeah, like, the damage output is wild. We're already at 600k an hour on the first three quarters of a loop. Try not to die, though, before we actually see the full XP range. And I guess that's the next question. Not the next question. A question. Do you guys, like, I don't know if anyone's still really invested in the series or not. Oh, well, may as well loot that. But do you want me to, like, compare different spawns or just kind of grind out the, you know, level 100? It would honestly just be between here and Savvy Surface. But I think I'd personally like to just try a few other spawns. Like, check out Porthole Paint, Giant Spiders. I know the XP is trash, but for the most part, at this level, people are just kind of bopping from spawn to spawn. You're not just going to, unless, you're not going to just, like, grind one area unless you're literally just power leveling. But I guess this series is more so for, oh, I'm going to die. No, for newer players. Because it was actually interesting to see, like, a few people posting, oh, I'm like, playing my first Druid and this was helpful. Like, it's nice to see that Tibia is getting new players, new player base this late. For the most part, it's just been us old school grinders making bomb characters. But that is one lap, and we're sitting at 800k an hour easy. So I'm going to cut to some music. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Hopefully I don't die before this. If you made it this far, thanks for watching. I might stream after I upload this video. I'm not 100% sure. 7 o'clock, I'm trying to limit myself to not being on after 10. So I think I'll have time to do a little hour or two stream. So come check me out on Twitch. I'm going to do a few on YouTube as well, but right now I'm going to stick to Twitch. Hopefully everyone's doing all right during these crazy times, and enjoy the video, and we'll pop back in at the end just to see a little summary of the hunt. All right, guys. Talk to you in a bit. Enough.
I've been thinking. Lately it's just me against the world. Round and round I'm caught up in this swirl, trying to dig and trying to burrow. Pressure turned this stone into a pearl. Lessons that I learned weren't always thorough, sugar-coated like a churl. Now I'm really out here on my own. Now my homies acting like I owe them, done extending out my arm. Made a lot of money from my poems. Been around and now they say I'm on. I can finally say I'm up now, I'm up now. 20,000 on a bus down, a bus down. I'm on my way, I'm going up now, up now. And I ain't never gonna touch down, touch down.
Sweet and spice, throw it all in a cauldron, mix it up real nice. Fire in my eyes, stir counterclockwise, I dream of you all night.
Alright guys, we are going to finish up the little hunt there. 20 minutes, kind of like to roughly what I do for my videos before I speed them up, obviously. I don't really want to send something, you know, 40 minutes of pretty boring hunting, so need a drink. Summarize, pretty solid. That's definitely the best XP I've ever gotten there, which I have to thank the damage output. Crazy. And I am certain you could push that. We peaked at just under 1.5kk, which... pretty good for a casual player, I think, but I could be wrong. It's been a while since I've really tested these. We got 400k an hour, or 400 XP gain in about 22 minutes of hunting or something, or not even. Like, not even. But we maxed out at 1.495, and I really think with proper rotation, which I don't have, as well as a better loop and, you know, better timed UEs, I think you push 1.7, 1.8 without a doubt. Like, I know you can. It can definitely happen. Just, you know, some tweaks need to be made on my end or on the hunter's end, which I never really thought. Ooh, that's, where's the layout? The fuck? Man, I don't know anything anymore. I'm such a noob. But yeah, I think that's pretty awesome considering how easy that spawn is. We only had one or two near deaths, and that was just stupid positioning on my part. And maybe even with the Terra boots and... switch out the Boots of Haste, put on Terra Boots and a Time Ring instead, just to keep that mobility, but to lessen the damage taken. But it's really not that bad, especially at this level. You can just go full magic set, probably. and, you know, really increase your XP. But I think 1.8kk is doable. I've never really put any research into see what the highest I've seen before, but again, pretty solid little spawn. Next video, I think we'll go for our first demon. I was just kind of thinking about that. I haven't done anything really exciting or cool. I know it's not that hard anymore, but four level back in the 80, or level 80 back in the day, a demon would have been like, holy shit, that's crazy, man. So we'll kind of throw some nostalgia back there. But that's it for now, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. Questions, comments, concerns, negative, positive, don't matter. Just leave them in the comments below. Leave a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you soon. Peace.